Hi guys, this is Mike, otherwise known as the Wizard of Odds, and this video is my list of the top 10 best bets in the casino. Now, before I get into the games, let me get some housekeeping stuff out of the way. First of all, how do I measure how good a game is? I go by what I define as the element of risk on my website. This is the ratio of how much the player can expect to lose to the total amount of money that he bets in that game, including subsequent wagers like doubling in blackjack and raising in Ultimate Texas Hold'em. I think this is a better measurement than the House Advantage, which considers the expected loss to the initial bet only, which I think makes games like Ultimate Texas Hold'em look worse than they really are, because the player is betting so much more additional money in those raises. Next, which games am I even considering for this list? Now, I admit a bias for right here in Las Vegas to the games that you can easily find here. I know that the game availability is different from place to place, so I apologize for that. I do try to keep my eye on also what is available nationwide. I've done the best I can, but I am considering only games that are fairly easy to find. I'm not going to include some obscure game that can only be found at the Brass Ass in Cripple Creek, for Colorado, for example. Next, when I quote any House Advantage or Element of Risk figures, I'm assuming very good strategy by the player, sometimes optimal strategy, sometimes a very good basic strategy that gets you close to optimal strategy. So with all of my gambling videos, I highly recommend that you do your homework and learn proper strategy on how to play before you play, because if you don't, it's going to cost you a lot of money. But some of the games on my list here require no strategy at all other than bet selection, which is also very important. So, but there you go. For games of skill, I expect the player to know how to play properly. And finally, what did I want to say? I wanted to say that for blackjack and video poker, it's kind of difficult to say what the element of risk is or the house advantage, because the rules vary so significantly from one table to the next, one casino to the next, one state to the next. It can vary all over the place. So I am trying to look at games that are very good games, very good sets of rules, yet are realistically findable. Not necessarily every casino will have these rules, but in competitive environments, you can go to various sources and find out who has the best set of rules and then play them. So with those housekeeping things out of the way, I think I'm ready to get right into the list. Number 10, Mississippi Stud. Now, Mississippi Stud is one of the more popular new poker variants out there. It's not so new anymore. It's been around for a while. It's a very simple game where the player is paid based on the poker value of a five-card hand. He doesn't need to beat the dealer. He starts out by getting two cards, and he has the opportunity to raise, and then he can has two more opportunities after that to raise even more. So there's a pay table, and the player is paid according to how much he bet and his final poker hand. The strategy to it is not too complicated. Like all strategies, they can be found on my website. I also have these nice little laminated cards, one-fourth the size of a piece of paper, that indicates the proper strategy there. So if you follow that strategy on my website, Mississippi Stud has a house advantage of 1.37%, and I consider anything under 1.5% to be pretty competitive. So there you go. Number 10, Mississippi Stud. Number 9, Roulette. Now, I hesitated to put Roulette on this list because the way most players play it, on a American double zero wheel, the house advantage is 5.26%, which is average at best. However, if you look around and you have a large bankroll and are comfortable with a $100 minimum bet, which is usually the case, you can find a wheel that has only one zero, and if you make an even money bet and the ball lands in zero, then you only lose half. And that will cut the house advantage down to a nice low 1.35%. So there you go, roulette, but only if you can find those French rules with a single zero and half back if the ball lands in zero on even money bets. And once you do find that wheel, then only make even money bets. Don't make anything else, because if the ball lands in zero, you'll lose everything except if you bet on a zero. So there you have it. Number 9, roulette. Number 8, baccarat. And here is another game that is nice and easy to play. It's like betting on the flip of a coin. If you bet on the banker only, which is how you should play, you'll enjoy a nice low 1.06% house advantage. If you must bet on the player, it jumps up to 1.24%. Just don't bet on the tie, the player pair, the banker pair, or any other side bet in the game. Stick to the player and the banker, preferably the banker only. I know no one plays that way, but if you want to play properly and get that house advantage as low as possible, then bet on the banker only. So there you have it. Number 8, baccarat. Number 7, paigao. And no, I do not mean paigao poker. I mean paigao played with 32 tiles that look like these. I was a little hesitant to include paigao in the list because it's getting a little bit difficult to find, especially in smaller markets. Nevertheless, it's a great game. It has a house advantage of 0.08% when you're banking, and when you're not banking, it's 1.98%. If you're playing by yourself, you can bank half the time, which results in an average house advantage of 1.03%, which is really quite good. Not only that, but paigao is a low volatility game. It's only 30 to 40 hands an hour. There's a lot of pushes. So if you're looking for a way to play without a lot of risk, paigao is a great choice. It's also a very challenging game. The rules are a little bit involved to learn, but if you like a good challenge in the casino, I highly recommend you try it. And by the way, those house advantage figures were based on my basic strategy, which I have on my website. It's also on this little strategy card here, which is 1/4 the size of a piece of paper, which goes to show you that the strategy is not that bad. And it can be improved upon, by the way, beyond the basic strategy. But the basic strategy is what I play. I think it's a good balance between simplicity and power. So there you have it. Number 7, paigao. Number 6, Spanish 21. And this is another one I hesitated to put on the list because it's getting pretty difficult to find here in Las Vegas anymore. Nevertheless, I know it's really popular in California, Washington, and Atlantic City. So I definitely think it's a worthy game to be included. Because if I didn't put it, then everyone would be writing to me and saying, Wiz, how come you didn't put Spanish 21 on the list? So Spanish 21 is a variant of blackjack. They take the tens out of the deck, but they add in lots of rules that favor the player. I go through all the strategy and the rules on my website. And by the way, do not play blackjack basic strategy in Spanish 21, which most people do. Spanish 21 calls for a much different kind of strategy. So if you're playing Spanish 21 under, shall we say, the normal rules, where the dealer hits us off 17 and you cannot double after doubling, then the house advantage is 0.76%, which is not bad. But it is not too difficult to find a game where you can redouble. That is, say you get a 9, double, get a 2, and now you have 11, and then you can double again. So if you can find that redoubling rule, that lowers the house advantage to 0.42%. Also, if you can find a game where they stand on a soft 17, which is can be easily found in Atlantic City, that also lowers the house advantage to 0.42%. It's just a coincidence that both rules are equally as good. So Spanish 21, in many casinos, if they have both blackjack and Spanish 21, lots of times Spanish 21 will be the better bet. So remember to play it properly. But if you have the option to play Spanish 21, definitely consider that. It's a good game. Thanks. Number 6, Spanish 21. Number 5, Blackjack, good old blackjack. It can be found everywhere. It's highly available. With blackjack, you got to be careful of a couple things, that you're playing with a competitive set of rules and you're playing properly. If you do both those things, you can cut down the house advantage to roughly around 0.5% or even less. Right now here in Las Vegas, it's not difficult to find a set of rules in the Caesars owned properties where the dealer hits us off 17, 8 decks, blackjack pays 3 to 2, which you should always insist on, and they allow surrender. If you can find those rules, the house advantage is 0.56%. At a lot of the MGM Mirage casinos, they have those same rules, but they cut the number of decks to 6, and they allow resplitting of aces. That'll cut the house advantage to 0.46%. And by the way, the element of risk is going to be a little bit less because of the doubling and splitting. So, yeah, the rules for blackjack vary all over the place. The one thing you want to avoid above all else is never play 6-5 blackjack. That means where a winning blackjack will pay 6-5 as opposed to 3-2. Always insist on that full 3-2. That advice supersedes everything else that I say about blackjack. If you do play a 6-5 game, that'll increase the house advantage by 1.35%, which throws a great bet just out the window and suddenly you're playing a mediocre game. So there you have it, number 5, blackjack. Number 4, Ultimate Texas Hold'em. Now this game does not get nearly the respect it deserves. This is a great bet if played properly. As many of you know, Ultimate Texas Hold'em is a game where you play against the dealer in a Texas Hold'em based game. It offers an opportunity to raise at some point in the game. The earlier you do choose to raise, the larger your raise bet can be. Now, the strategy to Ultimate Texas Hold'em, the optimal strategy is super complicated, but I have a very simple strategy on my website, which also can be put on a strategy card 1/4 the size of a piece of paper, like that one there. It can be found on my website as well. So, the element of risk in Ultimate Texas Hold'em is nice, low, 0.53%, so about 0.5%. That is a great bet, but you got to play it properly, which few players do. I've played a lot of Ultimate Texas Hold'em, and most players just butcher the strategy. So be sure to go to my website and learn the proper strategy before you play. So there you have it. Number 4, Ultimate Texas Hold'em. Number 3, sports betting. And I'm not saying all sports bets are great bets. If you stick to just betting against the spread or the total, the average house advantage is 4.5%, but you can do much better than that by two simple words: home underdogs. If you stick to only betting those, then you can cut the house advantage way, way down. And I hesitate to put a specific number on it, but I'm going to conservatively say 0.5%. When I look at my NFL data, if you bet on home underdogs only against the spread, you would have only a 0.3% house advantage. And in Major League Baseball, you would actually have a player advantage of 0.55%. And I'm not saying that you can, against the 10-cent line, by the way, and I'm not saying that you can enjoy a 0.5% player advantage in baseball by only betting home underdogs, because there's a little bit of a small sample size error there. Nevertheless, the data bears this out in every single sport: home underdogs. And yeah, and not only that, but sports betting is obviously also a really slow way to lose your money. You can make one bet and enjoy a game for 3 hours. That's much better than slot machines, where you get to enjoy the bet for 3 seconds. So there you have it. Number 3, an easy number 3, sports betting at conservatively a 0.5% house advantage. Number 2, video poker. And this was a really difficult game to put a house advantage figure on because games vary so much from machine to machine and casino to casino. And for this list, I'm considering what are the best, shall we say, findable games. I'm not saying that every casino has the very best games, and if they do, they may be at very high minimums. Nevertheless, skilled video poker players will be able to hunt down and find these games. And also, video poker is very much a game of skill. If you sit down at video poker and have no idea what you're doing, you're going to get killed over the long run. So this is definitely a game where strategy is important, and strategy can be a little bit complicated, but I have a ton of stuff on my website about video poker strategy, so don't hesitate to learn up about it. And a nice, simple strategy can also fit on something the size of one quarter of a sheet of paper, too. So, what are the best games in video poker? Here's what they are. 9-6 jacks are better, and that means that a full house pays 9 and a flush pays 6. That has a house advantage of 0.46%. 16-10 deuce is wild, also sometimes called not so ugly ducks. That has a house advantage of 0.27%. 8-5 bonus poker, that comes in at 0.83%. And 9-6 double double bonus, that comes in at 1.02%. Now, good old 9-6 jacks are better is definitely findable here in Las Vegas, and some casinos even have it at a reasonable bet amount. By the way, all those games can be found at the South Point. So these are definitely findable games. They might be a little bit difficult to find depending upon the casino that you're in, but if you want a great bet, video poker, you can't beat it. For so many players, that is the only thing that they play. So yeah. And especially if you're a slot machine player, that is one of the worst bets. And if you play reeled slots, I highly recommend that you convert to video poker. It requires work, but that work will definitely pay off in the end. So there you have it. Number 2, video poker. It's time for number 1. This is it. Here it comes, number 1. So for those of you under the age of 50, that's how they announced the number 1 song on the Dr. Demento show. And somehow I still can't get that out of my head. Anyway, number 1, the best game in the casino, most of the time, is going to be craps. That means that in most casinos, the best odds that you're going to find are on the game of craps. And the number I'm going to put on that is a house edge of 0.37%. But not everybody is going to realize those great odds. In fact, very few players are, because most players are suckers who make all the sucker bets in the middle of the table that you should absolutely stay away from. The way you get to 0.3% is by betting on only the pass and the come bets and back them up with the full odds, and I'm assuming 3, 4, 5 times odds. And you can actually get even better with that if you bet the don't pass or don't come and then lay the maximum odds, laying at 3, 4, 5. You can cut that house advantage down to 0.28%. So those are fantastic odds. And if you're not familiar with craps, you're not going to know what I'm talking about with those bets, but it's all explained on my website. And the odds. The odds bet has 0 house advantage, exactly 0. It pays statistically fair odds, but you can't bet that by itself. You have to bet it after you make a pass, don't pass, come, or don't come bet. But when you mix everything together, you get those great odds. But no matter what you do, stay away from everything in the middle of the table, the hard ways, the yo, all the hot bets, the any 7, all that stuff. Sucker bets. So there you have it. I'm not saying that in every casino, craps is the best bet. Sometimes it's blackjack. Sometimes it's video poker. Might be Spanish 21. Might even be Ultimate Texas Hold'em. Might even be something else. But most of the time, it's craps. And the great thing about craps is that it's really easy to get those great odds. It's all about bet selection. After that, there's no strategy to it. So craps offers a tremendous value if played properly. So there you have it, my 10 best bets in the casino. Hope you liked it. If you did, thumb me, or better yet, subscribe to my channel, and I will see you in the next video. Until then, may the odds be with you. This is Mike. Bye.